Hey everyone, welcome back to Shock Live. It's your trainer Ashley Steele and I'm so happy to be here today to lead you through another class. We have a full body blast workout on the books today and let's go ahead and get started. I'll tell you what you need to get done and crush this workout today. You're gonna need a set of weights. If you have a lighter set and a heavier set, go ahead and grab those since your strength tends to differ from muscle group to muscle group. If you just have one set of weights, that's completely fine. No worries there. You will need a resistance band. I have a couple different options here, a heavier one and a lighter one. If you have one of those, go ahead and grab it. You will need a chair just for one of our quick glute activation workouts. So if you have the edge of your couch, a bench, a chair, those will work perfect. Your water, of course, so you can stay hydrated throughout the workout, and possibly a sweat towel. I think you're gonna need it today. So if you're ready, let's go ahead and get started with our warm up. Go ahead and take a deep breath, get ready, get your mindset right, and let's dominate this workout together. So we're gonna start out, get our blood pumping. So let's start with air jumps. So fake jump rope right here to get quick and moving. Let's stay here for about 30 seconds. Speed it up if you feel good. Stay there on the balls of your feet. Whip your fake jump rope. If you have a jump rope, you can go ahead and use it. Good work. Keep it up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Let's go ahead and warm up those shoulder joints, upper body. Just give me some arm swings right here. Keep a slight bend in your knee here. Your core is tight. You're just swinging those arms back and forth. Good work. 3, 2, and 1. Let's take it down to your mat. Warm up that total body in a high plank here. Make sure those wrists are below your shoulders. Belly button pulled in towards your spine. Tighten your glutes. To make it a little bit easier, you can just take your feet wider. That'll help stabilize, give you a strong base. Good work, keep that neck neutral, core is tight. You can come down here on your knees if you need to, that's another option to make it a little bit easier. And hold for 3, 2, and 1. Good work, let's go ahead and start just with a little glute activation. We wanna make sure we really wake up those glutes since we are doing some lower body today. It helps to get them just warm, nice and prepared, and helps to wake up those stabilizer muscles there. Your glute, those smaller muscles that are in there in your hips that you want awake to help the body move and work together as it should. So I'm going to take this light one. And if you have your bench or chair nearby, go ahead and grab that. We're gonna start with some seated abduction. So bring that band to just right above your knees, right here over your quads. Take a seat nice and tall. And we're just going to plant our feet on the floor about hip width and just drive those knees out, abducting, waking up those hip muscles. So let's stay here for a total of 30 seconds. Now you only need to drive those knees out as wide as where your foot starts to come up off the floor. Always a great burn to use these resistance bands. We'll use it throughout our workout as well, so keep it nearby. Good work, last 10. Let's stand up in 3, 2, and 1. You can go ahead and move that chair out of the way. We're not going to need it anymore. Next up, we have some squats with our resistance band on if you have it. So take your feet just outside of hip width. Sink those hips back, booty towards the wall. So you're gonna feel some resistance, that band pulling your knees in. What you don't wanna do is let it pull your knees in. You have to fight that resistance. Keep those knees in line with your toes. And just complete a bodyweight squat. Stand to this side here so you can see my knees are staying behind my toes. Drive through your heels, come back to the top, and squeeze your glutes, as always, at the top of the movement. Chest stays nice and tall. Let's do a couple more. Last one. Good work. Last exercise here for our activation. We're gonna do a banded hip hinge, so go ahead and put those toes over your band. I'll stand to this side here. So all the movement here, coming right here from your hips. So you hold that band. Your trunk comes down, your back stays nice and tall. Press through those heels to come back up to the top and squeeze those glutes. So you'll probably recognize this movement for when we use dumbbells in our RDLs, which we will be starting with today. Let's get down to business. Girl, you've been on my wish list. Way more than bad, you vicious. Pussy clean, delicious. Won't doubt it, I know you. So you'll notice I have a slight bend in my knees. That's all the knee movement you're gonna have here. Let's get down, let's get down to business. Good work. Give you one more night to get this. 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Go ahead. Take that band. Pop it to the side. We won't need it here to get started. So grab some water. Good. So we're going to start with that RDL. We'll be doing our moves for anywhere from 30 to 40 seconds, which means we'll have anywhere from 20 to 30 seconds of rest. We've got one circuit, 7 exercises. We'll be moving through 2 times. So it'll be about a 15-minute workout, give or take, with our rest in there. So get ready, start my timer, and let's move. But we can live them if we stay the same. I can't do this for nothing. All right, let's go in 3, 2, and 1. So take those feet hip width. Remember, all of our movement is coming from our hips here. Slight bend in our knees. Back stays straight as we come down to about mid shin with those weights. And something that you'll notice that I do is I literally keep my finger out to touch my leg. My finger never leaves my leg. That's a good guiding point because you don't want to have your weights out here in front of your body. Squeeze those glutes to the top. Last 3, 2, and 1. Good work. Next up, we have lateral raises. So grab those lighter weights if you need. Shoulder blades stay down. Arms come out to the side. We go in 3, 2, and 1. So always get your base down. Feet are hip width. You have a slight bend in your knee. Arms come up to about shoulder height. You don't need to go any further than that. Your core stays strong. Good, let's move for 10 more seconds. You know we're gonna get some shoulders in there. One of my favorite muscle groups to work out. Really helps to tone the total arm. 2 and 1, nice job. Okay, so next up, we've got a static lunge. We'll be switching halfway in between, swapping those legs. So just wanna get a nice base. Put your weight up here. Lower those hips. 2 and 1, let's go. So notice right here, both my knees are bent at 90 degrees at the bottom. I'm pressing through that front heel to drive up, to extend my legs. And my trunk here is slightly angled forward. It just helps for my mechanics. So if you don't feel right, you can do the same. One other thing you wanna make sure you notice, go ahead and switch legs right here, is that you don't want this back leg to be too close to your front leg because that's gonna throw off your balance. It's not correct form. Last 2 and 1. All right, next up we have reverse fly. So we bend down here, hinging at the hips, bringing those weights up. Slight pause at the top, neck is neutral. Let's go in 2 and 1. Squeezing those shoulder blades together at the top. I'll move to the side here so you can see. I'm hinging at the hips, slight bend in my knees. My back stays straight. Slight pause at the top. Really squeezing those shoulder blades together. Stay in control of your breath here. Hang with me for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take it down to the floor. Grab that band. We have a glute bridge with some abduction. So again, we're driving those knees out at the top. So when our hips come up, those knees pulse out. Then back down. So just give me one pulse at the top. Let's move in 2 and 1. One thing to focus on here is you want your hips, knees, all the way to your shoulders in one straight line. Another thing you don't want to do is overextend your spine. So when you're here at the bottom, go ahead and drive that lower back to touch the floor. You're just tilting your pelvis. That helps to not overextend your back and keep your body in a straight line. 2 and 1. Whew. All right, good work. You can pop off that band. We have a modified push-up up next. So you're here on your knees. Let's go in 2 and 1. So again, wrists under your shoulders here. Keep those elbows close to your body. And I'll be honest with you guys, this is one of my weakest points for me personally. Is my chest, so I'm really trying to focus more on training my chest, pushing myself with my weights. Mechanically, it's just always been a challenge for me. So if you can get up there in a regular push-up without your knees, go ahead and do it. Last 2 and 1. Whew. All right, to round out our circuit, we have leg raises. Flip back over. We're here. You can put those hands slightly under your booty. Put them in the air. Down, keep your heels off the floor. And back up. So if that's too much of a challenge for you, just do one leg at a time. And we're here for 40. Try and keep your legs straight. Good work, you guys. We're almost done with round one. Move through one more time and then we are done for the day. Last two and one. All right, hop back up. We've got our RDLs to start, so grab those weights. Get a quick sip of water if you need. Whew. All right, we move in three, two, and one. Feet are hip width. Booty goes back towards the wall. Back is straight, slight bend in your knee. Power through those heels. As you come back up to the top, give me that booty squeeze at the top. Good work, last 10. Four, three, two, and one. Lateral raise up next. Guys, we only have two rounds through this circuit. This is our last round through, so focus, give it your effort, push yourself. Grab those heavier weights if you can, because we want to get better and we want to get stronger today. Lateral raise in two and one. Nice strong base with your feet. Right at hip width. Slight knee bend. When you come up, don't let your shoulders shrug up. You want to keep those shoulders down, those shoulder blades compressed down. We gotta stay on point with our form. Come on, last 10. Four, three, two, and one. Static lunge up next. We switch halfway through. Bring that weight up. I'm gonna start with my left leg. So I'm here. This is what I was talking about earlier. If your back leg is too close to your front leg, this is what it's gonna look like. It's gonna feel weird. Take a step back. We move in two and one. Both knees bent at 90 degrees at the bottom of the movement. Power through that heel in the front to stand. Good, we switch in two and one. Both toes pointed forward. If you're having a stability challenge, you can grab onto a chair. You can hold that empty-handed arm out. Tighten your core as well to help keep balance. Last two and one. Good work. We're halfway through. We're on reverse fly. So remember, we hinge down at the hips, our back is straight. We're really using our back and those rear delts to fly those weights up. Soft, slight pause at the top, let's go. Neck stays neutral. Core is tight as well. Here we're toning the back of those shoulders into our back. Good work, squeeze your back. Here we go. Last five. Push through with me. Two and one. Good work, everybody. So we're down to the floor. We have that glute bridge with abduction. You're welcome to throw in a weight here to take it up a notch. Maybe if you did body weight the first round, we're throwing in some weight here. That's what I'm gonna do. Let's move in two and one. So drive through those heels, hips up, abduct those knees out. Just one pulse out to the side. Remember, don't overextend your back, sticking out that belly. I'm gonna try to imagine a straight line all the way from your knees to your shoulders. Keep pushing. Last four, three, two, and one. Nice, we flip it over for a modified push-up. So pop that band off. We're almost there. Last two exercises right here. Modified push-up, 30 seconds. Two and one. Good work, push through. Chest is a challenge for me, like I mentioned earlier, come on. Last five. Good work. Leg raise to finish it out. Stay with me here, you guys. Get a little rest. Control your breathing. And we move in five, four, three, two, and one. Last exercise, leg raises. So remember what I said earlier, one leg at a time. If you need to take it down to an easier modified version of this. Everyone else, push through both legs. Keep those heels off the ground. Last 10. Three, two, and one. Woo. Oh my goodness. Incredible work, you guys. Grab some water. We pushed through today, challenged our total body. I am sweating big time. Here's the end of our rest in two and one. Okay, we're officially done now. We don't have a finisher today. Nothing crazy to end it. There we go. Powered through that and we got done in less than 15 minutes. Those are always the perfect workouts whenever you're on the go. You just are in between work and lunch, maybe you want to take your lunch hour to get in a quick 15 minute workout. Sometimes that's all the time that you have. And that's what we have to do. We have to throw in our workouts when we can, where we can. We have so many body weight quick workouts that were specifically programmed and included in the app to be as flexible as possible so you can still get in your workout. So keep those in mind. I've also done several of the live workouts to be body weight as well, because I know that we don't always have access to equipment whenever we want to work out. So guys, incredible job today. Thank you so much for meeting up here with me. Invite a friend, invite a family member next time. Just as a reminder, if you have family members that also want to use the app, you can go into your iPhone settings and turn on that family sharing, and you can actually share your subscription with your family members. So, hey, that's incredible. I had someone email me about that the other day and it reminded me of it. And I was like, I need to remind people that they can do that because it's awesome and you don't have to pay for an extra subscription. So have an incredible rest of your day. I will see you next time.